Hello everyone and welcome to Mango Monkey Learns Money. In my channel, I want to give you guys ideas on how to become a millionaire, and I truly believe that this is possible if you invest $100 per week consistently and earn at least 4% per annum, and you keep doing that for the next 55 years. One of the ways that you can get the millionaire status faster is by finding alpha, and that is finding excess return over and above the stock market average. This is also referred to as abnormal rate of return because it is not normal, and you will need an element of luck and an element of genius. So today, I will give a shot at finding alpha and becoming a genius myself by analyzing a company called Wiser. The ASX ticker code of this company is WZR. Wiser is an online personal loan company. They have no branches. They also use digital tool provided by Credit Sense to analyze your bank statement, so they do not need to scroll through your 3-month bank statement line by line and spend an hour to assess each application. Recently, they have also started to offer car loan, that is a personal loan with a lower interest rate because it is secured against the car that you are buying. So what do I think about Wiser? I'm going to look at their recent investor presentation in October, where they provided an update on their July to September quarter. They grew their loan origination by 132% compared to the same quarter last year, and they grew their revenue by 358%. Revenue should be their interest income and loan establishment fee. So for most lending companies, the growth in revenue should be similar to the growth in the loan origination. But in the case of Wiser, they previously used off-balance sheet funding model where the loans they originated were not really their loans, and they did not take on the credit risk. Therefore, they only collected a small management fee. Now that they have started to take on credit risk, their revenue has become around 3 times of what they earned when they didn't take on the credit risk. So what I'm really interested to know is their credit performance. Wiser takes on only the prime borrowers. They offer lower interest rates compared to the big 4 banks and some of the other online lenders like Now Finance and Latitude. Their starting interest rates seem to be a little bit more expensive compared to Plenty, which was previously known as Rate Setter. The average income of Wiser's customer is $86,000 per annum, and that's actually really high. They do ask for proof of income of the borrower's husband or wife to make sure the family as a whole has sufficient income to support the household expenses. This is a very good way of lowering the credit risk. A lot of the big banks and some of the non-bank lenders like Latitude only ask for proof of income of the person borrowing the money. The average customer credit score for Wiser is 714, which is a really good score. As of September 2020, 1.01% of their loans are classified as in arrears over 90 days late, on top of the 2.2% which are on the COVID-19 payment assistance. So that is a total of 3.21% in risky loans. I'm going to compare this to Plenty, which was known as Rate Setter, next week. But today, I will compare Wiser with Prosper. Please note that Prosper is a completely different beast because they lend to business owners for business purpose. But I'm comparing them anyway for my own personal investment purpose because I'm trying to decide between the two companies. As of June 2020, Prosper had 7.95% of their loan book in arrears over 90 days. It is not clear whether this includes the loans deferred due to COVID-19 or not, but they had 15.3% of their Australian loans in full or partial deferral at the end of August. So Wiser has 3.21% in Risky Loans. On the other hand, Prosper has between 15% and 23% in Risky Loans. Wiser's leverage is around 2.4% at the end of June 2020. That is, for every dollar of net asset, they have around $2.40 worth of loan book funded by their warehouse facility. I am excluding the off-balance sheet loan book because they don't take on the credit risk for this portion of their loan book. So I divided their $86 million warehouse funded loan book by the $36 million in net asset at the end of the financial year. If I look at their loan book in September this year, assuming their net asset is still the same, their leverage is around 3.7 times. Their warehouse facility has been increased to $250 million, so you can expect their leverage to go all the way up to 5.5 times. The loan that was wrote off in FY20 was around 0.46% of their loan book, so if I multiply this by 5.5 times, I get 2.53%, and that is still a very small portion of their loan book. Prosper's leverage, on the other hand, is around 2.9 times. The loan that they wrote off in FY20 was 9.51% of their loan book. So multiplied by 2.9, I get 27.6%. And that is the risk I have in my equity position, probably on an annual basis, depending on if Prosper continues writing off their loan every year. I also want to know their price to book ratio. Wiser's market capitalization as of 25 October 2020 is $208 million. Their book value is around $36 million, so that's a price to book ratio of around 5.8 times. Prosper's price to book ratio is around 0.9, which you can see in my video last week. So from a book value perspective, Prosper seems to be the better value. Now at this point, I'll appreciate it if you can help gently tap the like button so that I can get more views on YouTube. Now let's look at the operating costs. Wiser's operating costs add up to around 22% of their combined loan book. Wiser is the second lender I've ever looked into. Next week, I will look into Plenty so that I can compare. At this stage, I do not know whether 22% operating cost is good or bad. What I can see is that Wiser's interest income is only around 3.4% of their combined loan book, and most likely around 12% per annum of the loan book funded by their warehouse facility. So it does not make sense for them to keep going unless a lot of the operating costs are fixed costs and they will achieve economy of scale. If I look at their October investor presentation, I see that they have just achieved core business cash flow profitability in the second half of the 2020 financial year. They have something called growth operating expenses, which predominantly consists of investments into the Wiser ecosystem, and that is the Wiser Credit, Wiser App, and strategic partnerships, along with preliminary rollout of the secured vehicle loan product. For me, I do not think that the secured vehicle loan will be a big income driver for Wiser because the interest rate starts from 6.7%, and I know that is still higher compared to finance companies who actually focus on offering car loans. The Wiser Credit and Wiser App may help them generate leads and they may work well, but I will need to look into that a little bit more, and I will do that on another day. Wiser does have a big market to grow into. At the moment, they only have around 0.45% of the personal loan market, so it is definitely a big market out there. I think their credit risk is relatively small. I mentioned before that Wiser wrote off 0.46% of their loan book during FY20, and with 5.5 times leverage, this turns out to be around 2.53% of the net asset of the company. So for me, the question is whether there is economy of scale if Wowser keeps growing. I need to understand more about how much their operating costs will grow each time they double their revenue. Unfortunately, I do not have the answer right now, but over the coming weeks, I might try to look into it further. But for now, I will sit on the sideline and I will look at the newly listed Plenty next week. As you can appreciate by now, researching a particular company takes a lot of hours. It is time-consuming and it is not worth doing unless you are investing a large amount of capital. So if you're only investing small money, just put it into an index ETF and you will probably do better than if you choose your own company anyway. If you want to see my analysis of Plenty, please do remember to subscribe to my channel so you will be notified when the video comes out. Have a great weekend!